I believe that the world we are currently inside of is such a place.
So then, this is some kind of a mirror server.
That's one way to put it. Patali, at one time, you had the power to distinguish Ida's sound from all others.
Ida's sound?
Come to think of it, didn't you say something like that when we found Indie Glut Lou?
Well, if you mean hearing strange sounds and seeing bug-like things, I've had that happen a number of times.
Have you heard that sound after being placed in your present condition?
No, I haven't.
I thought so. It all makes sense. It would seem that the data Ida stole from her is...
You don't mean... the young girl's Morgana Factor?
Morgana Factor? What's that?
Master Yala!
It's all right to tell him all about it now. The Morgana Factor is the specialized data that makes Epitaph users unique.
Epitaph users are special characters created by CC Corp for use during certain projects. Thus, Epitaph user PCs have data inside them that is not found inside regular PCs.
That's the Morgana Factor, usually called Epitaphs.
So the reason that we can use avatars is because we have that Morgana Factor? I mean Epitaphs?
That's right.
Hence, Epitaph users.
CC Corp wants to mass-produce Epitaph users.
You mean as a defense against Ida?
Yes, but thanks to strong protection protocols, we've been unable to adequately analyze them. We still don't know exactly what the Morgana Factor is.
Thanks to that, not only can't we mass produce, we can't even make a copy of it.
So why not just bring the creator in on it? He should be able to take care of that without a problem.
As far as we know, the Morgana Factor was not created by any one person.
Well then, how did you get a hold of him in the first place?
We managed to salvage it from the dark abyss of this world.
The abyss of this world?
Each of the Morgana Factors has its own name and identity. In my case, the name of my avatar is Tarvos, the Epitaph of the Avenger.
My avatar's name is Magus, the Epitaph of the Propagation.
As for haseo, his avatar goes by the name of Skaith. He is the Epitaph of... the terror of death.
The terror of death.
It's an odd coincidence that it's the same as your PKK nickname. Even with Magus's the propagation, we can't repair the Morgana Factor.
You
Thus, now that she has lost her epitaph user abilities, Atalie can no longer hear Ida's sound.
Maybe that's also part of the reason why Atalie lost her voice.
Yada, what can we do to help her?
There are no alternatives but to try to recover her Morgana factor from Ida. However...
What?
It will be difficult to trace Ida precisely, now that we are no longer on the actual CC Corp server. Fortunately for us, this Ida server is far from being perfect. This world contains seams in the structure. The fact that we can save our data is proof of that.
That means...
Yes, all we have to do is find them. It seems to me that at this point, our only acceptable option is to infiltrate the Ida areas and conduct a thorough search.
Infiltrate? You mean with just us? There's no way we could possibly cover all the Ida areas between just the few of us.
This is an emergency. We will reach out and ask other players for help.
That's pretty impressive, coming from someone as secretive as you.
Haseo, I believe you had a relationship with those at Moon Tree. You should go and ask them for help.
Moon Tree? Do you think there's a chance that they would really listen to me?
Moon Tree would never abandon someone in trouble! That's what Sakaki always said, that Moon Tree is there to help save people.
I will go and contact Zelkova myself. Hi, I want you to go with Haseo and help with his negotiations.
Yes, Master Yada.
What about me?
Atalie, you will stay here. If news of that arm were to spread beyond this group, it would only make things worse.
Okay.
Off to Moon Tree headquarters. Don't forget, the area words are Delta setting Eternity's Night Moon.
I'll be back.
Okay, I'll be waiting at the Chaos Gate.